We now come to the 10-minute rule motion. I call Sir Gavin Williamson.
Yeah.
Madam Deputy Speaker, I beg that leave be given to bring in a bill to require His Majesty's Government to recognise formally the Republic of Somaliland, to make provision in connection with the establishing of diplomatic relations with the Republic of Somaliland and for connected purposes.
Yeah.
If I can also draw the House's attention to the register of my interests. Madam Deputy Speaker, the 4th of July is often known as an Independence Day for another country, but I'm not here to talk about the United States, but actually the Republic of Somaliland. On the 26th of June in 1960, Britain granted independence to the British Protectorate of Somaliland. And it was in that euphoria, in that moment, that Somaliland a few days later entered into a union with the old Italian trust territories of Somaliland. But this proved to be a deeply unhappy union. Madam Deputy Speaker, that union, while it started off in hope, while it started off in optimism, ended up in tragedy. You saw the rise of a brutal military dictatorship based in Mogadishu, whose next steps were the persecution and the genocide of so many Somalilanders. Over the preceding years, you saw a genocide that unfolded that saw the loss of so many lives. You're not just talking about tens of thousands, but hundreds of thousands of lives. In the capital city of Somaliland, you saw Somali Air Force jets rising to the skies to drop bombs on the people of Hargeisa. 90% of the city was completely destroyed, but also not just in Hargeisa, but so many cities right across Somaliland. You saw so many of the nomadic tribes of Somaliland persecuted, with their only source of life, the wells that provided them vital water, being poisoned. Hundreds of thousands of people died in that genocide, and sadly, so much of the world did not notice or paid no attention. And it wasn't just the people that were killed. Every single family in Somaliland was affected by this, that was touched by this violence. But so many families were displaced, even within the own borders of Somaliland, or they had to flee to neighbouring countries, such as Ethiopia and Djibouti. Now, we should take a great sense of pride in this country because, of course, we welcome so many of those Somalilanders to our shores, and they made this their home like so many Somalilanders have done in the past. And it's that connection, a connection that goes long before the independence, that actually ties our two nations together. Out of that genocide, out of that civil war, you saw the emergence once again of an independent country. In 1991, Somaliland was able to declare itself free of Somalia. It was able to stand proud and independent away from the persecution and the genocide that they had suffered for so long. But they have asked the world for over 30 years now for recognition. They have asked the world to recognise what is there on the Horn of Africa. And they've listened to countries such as Britain and the United States, France and Germany. This has turned to them and said, well, we expect certain things. We expect a democratic process, parliamentary elections, presidential elections. We expect a judicial process. We expect you to educate your boys and girls. We expect you to be welcoming and a safe place for people to visit. And Somaliland has delivered that. Yet they still wait. They still wait for recognition from countries such as Britain, the United States, France, Germany, and so many others. And that wait is too long. Madam Deputy Speaker, in Somaliland, You have a country that is doing everything that it believes that people expect a democratic, free country to be doing. But it does ask for something in return. The people of Somaliland over so many decades have been willing to look to Britain as a friend. In fact, when we were at our greatest need during the Second World War, the Somaliland people joined with us against our battle against fascism. They fought side by side with British soldiers. When I was in Hargeisa and visited the Commonwealth War Grave Cemetery, you saw British names in that cemetery and you saw Somalilanders' names in that cemetery. Blood was spilt by both our nations for those common values and common interests. But we now need to step up as a nation. We now need to do something more than actually just being there. It is time to recognise. For too long we have resisted that. We always find excuses for inertia and inaction. Now is the time for us to start to be brave and actually reward the people that are doing the things that we as a nation ask them to do. Somaliland does not live in the easiest of neighbourhoods. It has difficult neighbours. But being a democratic country, being a country that wants to educate its boys and its girls by having a judicial system that is fair and robust, these are things that we need to be rewarding. This is what we need to be putting on a pedestal to say, this is an example that we want others to follow. Madam Deputy Speaker, I say that if a government is not going to take the action that is required, let it be the British House of Commons that takes the lead. Let it be the House of Commons that leads the way. If the FCDO is deaf, let us show what the will is for us to recognise what is a nation. A country which has its own processes of judiciary, it has its elections, it has every function of a democratic nation that we want to see. So if the government is reluctant to do it, let this House do it. Let us make sure that we reward those who are doing what is needed and is required. As we look at Somaliland, you see a country that is developing. You see a country that has got investment coming into it. And I'd like to thank the British government for the investment in Berbera Port, the investment on the highway north to Hargeisa. But by the simple act of recognition, you can transform the lives of 5.7 million people, making every single one of them more prosperous, enabling Somaliland, a good ally of this country, to play a bigger role on the world stage and play a vital role in supporting the values that we in this House hold dear. Madam Deputy Speaker, I know that it may seem a very far off place. I recognise that maybe a nation of 5.7 million people does not seem significant to Britain, but it is significant. It plays a pivotal role in terms of Africa, and I urge this House to take the action that is required to support the Republic of Somaliland and make sure that we deliver for the people of Somaliland as they have defended what we value so dearly, which is democracy and freedom.
The question is that the Right Honourable Member have leave to bring in the bill. As Mayor of that opinion, say aye.
Aye.
Of the contrary, no. I think the ayes have it. The ayes have it. Who will prepare and bring in the bill?
Mr. Clive Betts, Sir Robert Buckland, Dr. Lisa Cameron, Alan Cairns, John Speller, Ian Paisley, Alex Shelbrooke, Paul Blomfield, Alexander Stafford, Kim Johnson, and myself, Madam Deputy Speaker.
Sir Gavin Williamson.
Thank you.
Republic of Somaliland Recognition Bill.
Second reading what day?
Friday the 24th of November, Madam Speaker.
Friday the 24th of November. Thank you.